This question has been taken from SBI PO mains 2017. It is again memory based question. And this question is about probability. Another thing that this question statement is so long that it was not possible for me to fit the statement on one single page. I have separated this statement into two pages. And after that questions will follow. There are three bags A, B and C. In each bag there are three types of colored balls, yellow, green and black. So you have three bags and each bag has three types of balls, yellow, green and black. This is about bag A. For bag B and C, I have created another screen. There I will take up about the bags B and C. After that, the questions will be there. Our first objective is to calculate the number of the different types of balls in each bag. Once we are able to calculate that, then we will be able to answer the questions. So let us start with bag A. Let us read the statement. In bag A, number of yellow colored balls are Y for this yellow. And number of green colored balls are G. Number of green colored balls are 4 more than the number of yellow colored balls. When one ball is picked at random, then the probability of getting a black color ball is this much. This statement will give us about the black color. And the value of Y is 18.2/11% less than G. This is one relation between Y and G. And one relation appears in the first statement. Green colored balls are 4 more than the yellow colored balls. First of all, let us solve this riddle. This one is difficult for many students and they run away by seeing such figures. Let's not do so. Let us face it. 18.2/11% is what? It will be 18 multiplied by 11 plus 2. Divided by 11 and for this percent we will bring 100 down. What does this become? 18 into 11 is 198 plus 2 is 200. 200 by 11 and this 100, they will give me 2 by 11. So this seemingly tough figure, it just translates to 2 by 11. Let us now, I'll erase it off and just take it as 2 by 11 and let us begin to crack this problem. So this I'll cut and write simply as 2 by 11. Now, green colored balls are 4 more than the yellow colored balls. I can write G is equal to Y plus 4. One thing. And I have the last statement also. Let me write it also. This says Y is 2 by 11 fraction less than G. So Y is equal to G minus 2 by 11th of G. So this fraction is taken on G only because it is less than 2 by 11 of G. So it means G minus 2 by 11 of G. This comes to 11 minus 2 is 9. 9G by 11. This is okay. Now I will put the value of Y from here into the first equation. And when I put it there, what I get is G is equal to. So write 9G by 11 plus 4. Which implies, now we can orally take it up, take 9g by 11 to the other side. You will get 2g by 11. And therefore g will be 4 into 11 by 2, 44 by 2. That is equal to, g is equal to 22. And once you have g equal to 22, we can come back to this one and obtain y is equal to 18. Now I have obtained the number of green balls and yellow balls. And now is the time to turn to this one. When one ball is picked at random, then the probability of getting black ball is this much. Now we have a box. It has 22 green and 18 yellow and let us say B black balls. What is the probability of picking a black ball? The probability is the number of black balls, the chances that favor a black ball is equal to the number of black balls divided by the sum of all the balls by the total possibilities in which you can take out one ball, number of ways. So it will be 22 plus 18 plus B, that is equal to B by, this is 40, plus B equal to 5 by 13. Now orally, 13B and 5B, 8B comes to this side. 8B is equal to 40 into 5. Orally, I am doing mentally. So B will come to 25. So now I have all the contents of bag A with me. G, Y and B. I have all the figures. I will note it down somewhere and proceed to the bags B and C because I must solve those bags also before I am able to answer the questions. Let us move to the bags B and C now. In bag B, number of yellow colored balls is 22, 2 by 9% more than that of bag A. Now what is this 22 by 9%? Let us solve this riddle first. It will be 22 into 9 plus 2 whole divided by 9. Which is equal to 198 plus 2 by 9 and this percent will bring me 100 down and ultimately it is 200 by 9 and therefore this is simply 2 by 9. So let's write this one at least. This is 2 by 9. Number of yellow colored balls is 2 by 9 more than that of bag A. Then that of bag A means the number of yellow colored balls contained inside bag A. So in this case, the yellow colored balls are equal to the yellow colored balls in bag A that we have already calculated as 18. To that you add, it is how many? It is 2 by 9 more. So 18 are already there. To that you will have to add 2 by 9 of the value there. This becomes 22. So at the outset we have the number of yellow balls in bag B as 22. Let us now proceed further. If two balls are picked, I'll just erase it off so that I get space. And now I'm writing y equal to 22. Y equal to 22. If two balls are picked at random from bag B, so let us picturize it. This is your bag B. Then the probability of getting both green ball is 4 by 37. There are some number of balls here. And if you pick out two balls, then both are green is 4 by 37. Total number of balls in bag B is 75. So you have 75 balls in this bag. And the probability of picking two green balls is given to us. So, this is a bit tricky part. Let us see. Number of ways of picking two balls, the order won't matter. There is no concept of first ball or second ball. You are picking them together. So in this case, the combination will apply and we will write the total number of balls is 75 factorial divided by 75 minus 2, because you are to pick 2 balls, n minus r formula, and this 2 factorial will come because the order doesn't matter. So this is a combination that will apply, not permutation. You will have to think a bit. So the formula, if I remind you, is n factorial divided by n minus r factorial into r factorial. The number of ways in which you can take out r balls out of a bag containing n balls is given by this formula. This r factorial is because it doesn't matter whether on your palm you have first ball as green or the other as, because that is treated as one single combination. Permutation is not taken into account in this case. You will have to think about it. Okay, so this one comes to, this is 73 factorial. So I can write it as 75 into 74 divided by this 2. This 73 factorial cancels out with the remaining part. 75 into 74 into 73 factorial, that 73 factorial has got cancelled with this one and you are left with this figure. I am not calculating it, keep it as such. Okay. Now you are picking two green balls. Number of ways of picking two green balls will be equal to the total number of green balls, let that be g, divided by g minus 2 factorial into 2 factorial, again the combination, because green balls will be picked only from the green balls only. So this one comes to g into g minus 1, g minus 2 factorial will get cancelled out, divided by 2. So that's clear. Now I have been given the probability as 4 by 37, so all I can do is this probability is what I've actually forgotten the figure, 4 by 37. Okay. So what is g into g minus 1 divided by 2, the whole divided by 75 into 74 divided by 2, this is given equal to 4 by 37. I hope this is clear. This 2 can be cancelled out and now I can write g into g minus 1 is equal to 4, this one, and if you are a bit calculative, this 37 and this will give me 2, this 2 moves to that side, into 2 into 75, which is equal to, now you can write it as 8, split into 3 and 25 becomes 25 into 24. Therefore, g should be equal to 25. Because 25 into 1 less, g into 1 less, compare, g should be 25. So we have calculated y as 22, g as 25, and total is 75. Therefore, g is 25 and there this is sorry a green only, yes. Therefore black balls should be equal to the remaining one, 75 minus 25 50, and 50 minus 22 is 28. So this is the quantity of balls for the bag B. We'll write it somewhere, and now I will take to bag C. This is a pretty long question, but let's go ahead. Now let's come to bag C. In bag C, the ratio of green colored balls and black colored balls is 7:5. So we can say G, the green balls are 7k and black balls are 5k. Total number of green and black colored balls is 36. So 7k plus 5k is given equal to 36. Therefore, k should be equal to, this is 12, and you will get 3. And therefore, green colored balls are 21 and black colored balls are 5 into 3, 15. If one ball is picked at random, then the probability getting one yellow is this one. So the probability of a yellow ball would be y divided by the number of y yellow balls divided by the total balls. Total balls are y plus the other two are 36. This is given equal to 7/13. Therefore, y should be, so orally, 13y, 7y, 6y. 6 into 7 is 42. So this is the entire count of balls in all the three bags. We have recorded them, and now let us move to the questions. So this is the first question, and this is where I have recorded whatever we have calculated so far. Bag A contains yellow this much, green this much, blue this one, and totaled also. So on the basis of this, we have to answer the question. If X number of yellow balls from bag B are taken and placed into bag A. This is your bag B and this is bag A, and X yellow are moved to this one. And 20% of the bag balls from bag A are taken and placed into bag B. 20% of black balls from bag A. How many are in bag A black? 25. So 20% of 25 would be this much, which is equal to 5. So you are moving 5 black balls into bag B. If we pick one ball from bag B, then the probability that the, have I mixed up the bags? No, it's okay. If we pick one ball from bag B, then the probability that the ball is black is 11/26. So how many blacks are in bag B? 5 have come from that side. And in bag B, 28 were already there black. So total black in bag B is equal to 28 already plus 5 that have come from bag A, and total in bag, total balls in B, in bag B 75 were already there, X were moved out, 5 came in. I have erased that by mistake, so I'll just write here. You are counting black balls in bag B. 28 were already there. 5 came from outside. And total was 75. X went out and 5 came in. This probability is equal to 11/26. And we have to find out the value of X. So this will be 33 and you can take 26 to this side, bring that 11 down and set it equal to 80 minus x, 75 and 580, and this one gives me 3, and 63 18 and 78 is equal to 80 minus x. Therefore, x should be equal to 2, which is the required answer for this question. So once you have the calculations, things they become simpler. But this is a lengthy question, no doubt about it. Let us move to the next question now. If one ball picked at random from each of the bags A and bag B, then the probability that both the balls are of the same color is what? A diagram would be required. This is bag A, this is bag B. Then find the probability that if one ball is picked at random, you pick one ball from here and one ball from here. The probability that both are of the same color. So when will they be of the same color? When you have yellow hair and yellow hair, or you have green hair and green hair, or B hair and B hair. Let us find out the probability that you pick balls from the two boxes and both of them are of yellow color. Start with this one. Now, what is the probability that you pick a yellow color ball from bag A? How many yellow are there in bag A? 18. So you will write 18 divided by, the total are 65, this much. And the probability that you pick a yellow ball from bag B is how much? 28 divided by 75. Now this event on the left side has no impact on the event on the right side. If it rains in India, then this probability has nothing to do with the rain in USA. Two different things, independent events. If you have two independent events, then their probability of simultaneous occurrence is the product of their probabilities. Simultaneous probability of two independent events is equal to the product of their respective probabilities. This is the basic fundamental theorem of probability. So if you have yellow on the left side and yellow on this side, the total probability that both of them are yellow would be this much. Similarly, for green, so the probability would be added, or probability of this event or this event, you have to add a plus sign there. For the green would be what? The figure for green on this side is 22 by 65 multiplied by 25 by 75. And likewise for the black one, it would be 25 by 65 into 28 by 75. This quantity plus this quantity plus this quantity. And of course, this sum is nowhere in the given options. So the answer in this case is none only. So this is how you take up this question. I know most of you must have found this part very difficult. So you will have to go through the probability theory. That is very important, and this question is not definitely a basic question. It is a bit of a higher level. This thing you can remember: simultaneous probability of two independent events is product of their respective probabilities. The probability of picking a ball from this one, yellow ball from this one, has no impact on picking a yellow ball on the other side. Two different events, two different boxes. So that together yellow, yellow, this is the probability. Together green, green, this is. Together blue, blue, this much. And our requirement is that both the balls should be of the same color. So the probabilities will add up. No, it is not that simple. When I say add up, there is of course a probability theory behind it. The union of probabilities. But in the meantime, you will have to just accept it that if you have this probability for both Y, both green, both blue, then either this event or this event or this event, they will occur if you add their probabilities. Sometime later I'll take a probability videos also, but right now I haven't them. So let us move on to the next question now. Difference between the number of green balls in bag A and bag C is how much percent more or less than the sum of the number of black balls in bags A and bag C together? Difference between the number of green balls in bag A and bag C. What is the difference? A is 22 and C is 21. 22 green, 21 green. The difference is 22 minus 21 equal to 1 ball. The difference is asked. The difference is how much percent more or less than the sum of the number of black balls. What is the number of black balls in bags A and C? 25 plus 15 is the total. Total black is equal to 25 plus 15 equal to 40. So this difference is how much more or less than 40. So that is what we have to actually find out. The required percent is equal to, that difference is 1, and the increase over 40. So you will write 40 minus 1, the absolute value, divided by 40, and this is to be multiplied by 100. The difference and this 40, what is the difference between the difference and 40? This is 40 minus 1. The ratio is over 40, multiply by 100, which is equal to 39 by 40 multiplied by 100. And you can cancel out 20, 22, 40 and 25, 100, which is equal to 95, 45, 4, 19 by 2, which is equal to 2918127 97.5%, which is the required answer.